Put, ready, down!
Alright, welcome back, YouTubers and Madden fans. This is Madden Money Shot, sniffing out the Madden cheese as always. I got some plays for you today out of the Eagles playbook. This particular playbook, to me, has got to be the best running playbook in the game. Motion, I might as well continue with that with the halfback counter weak. Every one of these run plays is really good. I'll probably show the power G and the halfback toss separately, but there's, you know, this one here's probably got the most unique motion. I'll go ahead and I'll match the motion I showed before. So we picked that halfback counter. So I'm just good, like I said, I was showing a motion with Selleck. So this one right here, you can motion Selleck over. I motion snap it, and you can see how Blunt's just not fast enough. Come on, bro. So I'm gonna make that same motion with Selleck that I showed in that circle route, and that's just gonna, you know, I'll motion snap it too before he gets set. I just want him to get out there. I really did a poor job of reading my blocks, but not too bad run though. But let's go ahead and let's do this a couple times. This here is probably gonna be beneficial from a little bit of a faster, a little bit of a faster back than I picked. I probably could have put LeGarrette Blount on the bench, but he's still doing the thing pretty good here. Yeah, this definitely would have been beneficial to put in my speed back, Barner, but it's still working out pretty good. So we're gonna go ahead, we're gonna use that power. I'm not gonna run this too many times because there's not a lot to it, but I am motion snapping before he gets set because I don't want him to lose his little bit of speed that he has as I run over my blocker's back. But I don't want to wait till he gets set. I want to snap him right when he gets past the left tackle. As you can see there, he's so slow that it just helps him get to his block a little bit quicker. And, oh, look at that shake and bake. Yo, Blount is the man. Like, he just, for a big back, I don't know how he has so much shake and bake. It's kind of incredible. I went ahead and I motioned the wrong guy there, so it's whatever. Let's go ahead and let's do this. And nobody blocks. That whole play was meant to be failed right there. If this outside linebacker gets wide, you'll have to go up the center from time to time. As you can see here, good block by 88. Oh, I should have kept going to the sideline. I don't know what I was thinking. That could have been much better. But that's okay. We'll go ahead and move on. Go ahead and I'll finish this up because there's two run plays, but they're both really similar. The power G and the toss. I mean, obviously the power G to hand off the toss is a flip of the ball. Maybe I'll show both because there are some differences. But with the setup is the same. We're going to go ahead. We're going to motion out Selleck. I still didn't put in my speed back, but that's okay. But basically here, you're going to have two pulling guards that get out. And that's going to be really what makes this play unique is different than the power G. The power G, you got one puller. This is actually a guard and a tackle. I said two pulling guards, but it doesn't really matter. I really should put in a speed back. It's really going to benefit me. But you know what? We'll go ahead and we'll just take Blount and do what we got to do. I mean, the speed back would have been gone there. So, I mean, Madden has the benefit of being totally loaded at good Madden backs. Here, I didn't even make that motion because it's not always necessary. It's still a good play. That's what I mean when I say this is the best running playbook in the game. I mean, it's just loaded with great running formations. And you know, these two tight end sets are just so deadly. There, I did the motion snap version. Like, there's a couple different ways you can do it. It's successful pretty much any way, this toss play. Yeah, sometimes you can just motion Selleck out just a little bit, snap the ball right away. He turns right back into the blocking. There, he didn't really block anybody until I made him a good until I made him a good blocker by shaking and baking the first guy. That was a nice run right there. Barner is the man, I'm telling you guys. Kenyon Barner, man, if you're like a CFM or something, or you want a cheap mutt card for salary, Kenyon Barner is just so good. I keep singing his praises. I did in the last video. I'm doing it again. Look at his speed. Look at his speed. Look at his speed. Nobody even, it's just like an old school cheat, man. I'm just outside and gone. Like, this dude is so nasty. So we'll go ahead and move on, because like I said, there's not a lot to that. Go ahead and I'll show this last one real quick because it is a little bit different. The power G was like so dominant last year. Such a nasty play. This year, not so much. It's kind of, maybe they muted it because a lot of people are putting out videos about it. But we'll go ahead and we'll show it. We'll see what it's still got. The power G, all you do is motion out the guy again. You know what I'm saying? I'm going to do the motion snap. But this blocking here sets up a little bit more inside than the toss. Not the best first carry. We'll go ahead and we'll do it again. But this one here, like I said, you're getting inside. I mean, I like these You know, I like these motion snap versions. Moving them outside, I'll show that a couple times to show you how good that does, but I'm getting good inside looks. We'll keep doing this the inside way. There, like I said, I just wanted to get on that corner. That's exactly what he's doing. And we're going to get shook. And we're going to get shook. Cam Barney, man, I'm telling you guys, he's so good. Every time I make a video with him, he's just amazing. Yeah, I wouldn't necessarily run it without the motion. As you can see, they're just getting to the point too quick. But if you want to motion them all the way out, I'll go ahead and I'll show that one time. Hopefully, the cornerback, he'll get to the cornerback. A lot of times, I feel like that cornerback just gets in. There you can see he lays a good block downfield. So it's still a pretty good play, but I like the motion snap the most. I think I had the most success with that. Your opponent's not really going to be able to, with all the motions I did with the tight end, they're not really going to be able to pay attention to what the differences are. You know, by the time you're motioning them out, they'll think of the plays just, you know, they'll probably think they have more time and it'll catch them off guard with the motion snap too, which I think is important. All right, the last play I'm going to run out of this formation, and I pretty much touched every play now. That's how good this formation is. There is no bad play. There's no wasteful play, with the exception of the 95 Mike and the halfback lead, because obviously there's not a lot going on there. Although they have, oh, the 95 Mike, when you take a look at it real quick, because the receiver's doing a pretty interesting blocking setup where basically it's like an option blocking thing, which is kind of successful this year. But I'm going to go ahead and motion in my man, Jeffrey, again. I tried to motion hike him, but it doesn't necessarily let me do that. But you can see here how he has an option to block one of two people, and he actually blocked both, which is interesting enough. But either way, this isn't like the biggest play, but it's definitely worth looking at. You can see here, that's just a really good alley right there, sealed by the receiver. I did motion him in that time. You don't necessarily have to do that. But like I said, this is just a really good blocking formation. I mean, you can see I'm getting easy 10 yards there. I don't know if motioning in Jeffrey is helpful or not. You could always play, you know, misdirection games by motioning out Burton so it looks like it's going to the other side, like a lot of the other run plays. But I actually find that Jeffrey's doing a better job left out. As you can see here, we get, he's just killing it on the block out there. Like, he just smashed that dude. I get a touchdown. I'm gonna call it a touchdown. I'm not sure if it was. But like I said, there's nothing, Burton's not doing anything. So if you want to motion him out just to make your opponent think, hey, that's where the ball's going, and then hit him with this like as a mixed direction play, it's definitely going to be a good option. So I don't really get a whole lot there, but it is what it is. Like I said, I'm going to run this once or twice more because Jeffrey, like I said, he's really impressing me out there as we get a nice, he's just sealing that corner way better in this formation. And I don't know if it's because he has the option, like it shows his blocking is like an option to block inside or outside, but he's basically just getting inside and holding that point like really well. As you can see here, we get another big play. Didn't quite hold the block that time. That would have been nice, but it's whatever. But this is a really good run play, you know, so have this in your book, for real. So like I said, I went over every run play except for the lead. I mean, how different can that be? But that 95 Mike was actually pretty good. I might have to institute that in future plays that I run. So here we go, last play, X fade. Go ahead and pick that. This one right here, I mean, there's not, if it's a cover three, what Ertz is doing is pretty good. This looks like an all-out blitz though. So what I want to do is I want to put Ertz on a slant, and you really have the option to motion in Jeffrey if you want, but I don't find the fade's really going to do much. So I'm going to put him on a streak, and that's basically the look. Your check down blunt, I don't really find is going to do a whole lot in the look that he has. I actually want him to turn up field. I should have put in a faster guy, but it's really, this play's really all about the tight ends. As you can see there, they are sending the house, so I got to float it up against the man coverage. But yeah, you can really leave blunt the pass block though, because I don't really find that anything he's going to do is really going to get you open too much or be that beneficial. Your three reads are all in the center anyway, so let's go ahead and let's keep it simple. And here we got that cover three beater pass led inside. So we'll just run this once or twice more. This is probably a pretty good goal line concept, considering that the options are pretty short. Like I said, we have great pass protection because I got both backs blocking now. If you wanted to put one of your running backs on something, I would say like the fullback and like a check and release or something might be the way to go. But considering Allen is not, he's my defensive tackle because I don't have another fullback, he's not going to really do too well with that. The running back, I mean, you could put the running back in that same check and release. Might be the way to go. It looks like we got a little two-man got a little two-man screen going on right there. But that wasn't really the plan. I would say just having Allen in a check and, or no, I'm sorry, not Allen, the running back in a check and release would probably be the best option if you want it, because he'll stay as a blocker if you need him, which is ideal. So here we go. I don't think that was a cover three. I'm not really sure. Bad throw, but it worked out. Yeah, I don't really think that the you're ever going to need the running back to do much. I mean, you know, I'm trying to give him something, but it's fine just to have him pass block. It's good enough. That'll do. These tight ends are going to get open. As you can see, they're getting open pretty much every time anyway. So real simple concept, real easy play. All right, so that's it. That's the video. If you guys want to see more Eagles or a full ebook breakdown, which I'm planning on doing, hit the like button or let me know in the comment section. I think this is a phenomenal run playbook. I used every play out of this formation, every single play except for the halfback lead, which is just a dive, which you don't really need to see. So that's it. Other than that, thanks for watching, man. Moist it out. Need more help or just want to show your support? Then head over to my Patreon and join my team, where you can get exclusive content like ebooks and bonus plays, as well as early access to my bids and more. Link in the description below.